Oil spills suck. Some of them gush millions of barrels worth of oil into the ocean. How do you even clean up a mess like that? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. On April 20th, 2010, an oil rig in the Gulf of Mexico exploded, spewing thousands of barrels of oil into the coastal waters a day. The pipe was finally capped 87 days later. 5 years later, 2-6% or possibly more of the oil still lays on the ocean floor. Scientists are still assessing the damage to ecosystems and to the people who live there. So how do oil spills like that get cleaned up? What happens to all of that oil? Well, the first step, contain the spill. Oil is insoluble, so it doesn't mix with water. Instead, it just floats on top in a layer just a few centimeters thick. Temporary floating barriers, called booms, corral the oil. Above the surface, the barriers kind of look like a string of floating body pillows circling the oil. Below the surface, they have a little skirt of material that extends a few feet to catch any oil below. Once the oil is rounded up, it can be scooped up with skimmers that are kind of like what you might use to get bugs out of a pool, only bigger. If that doesn't work so well, dispersants or chemical emulsifiers can be sprayed. Some dispersants contain surfactants, the stuff that makes detergents clean your clothes. They break up the oil and other dirt because their molecules have opposite ends. One end is hydrophilic, meaning it likes water, and the other is oleophilic, meaning it likes oil. These break up the surface tension that stops water and oil from mixing. By breaking up the oil, it makes it disperse more easily into the water, which could keep the oil from reaching the shoreline and damaging fragile wetland ecosystems. But some research shows that dispersants are toxic to coral, so maybe they aren't the best idea for every spill. What other tools do we have? Absorbents like clay and straw soak up some of the spill, but they also soak up a lot of water, so they're not ideal. Fortunately, science is on the case. Scientists from a Swiss materials research institute called EMPA had developed a kind of sponge made from chemically modified wood called nanofibrillated cellulose. The material soaks up oil but leaves water behind, and in lab tests, they said they have absorbed up to 50 times their own weight of oil. Another really cool engineered sponge was recently created by Ohio State University scientists. The nature-inspired technology is described in a paper published in the journal Scientific Reports. Inspired by lotus leaves, the stainless steel mesh is coated with silica to create a bumpy exterior. On top of that bumpy layer is another layer of surfactant, and finally, it's sealed with a polymer coating that repels water. One of the researchers says that a combination of these layers makes for nanoparticles that bind to oil. They're hoping the mesh could one day be used like a giant sponge, soaking up a nasty oil spill. Both of these technologies are still in the early development phase, though, so it may be a while before they're put to use in real disasters. As for the oil that washes up on shore, sometimes nature can take over, sometimes with a little help. Biological agents like enzymes or microorganisms can be added to help speed up the biodegradation process. According to the EPA, this can either involve bioaugmentation, where bacteria is added to the spill site to help biodegrade the oil, or biostimulation, where nutrients are added to already present oil degraders to stimulate growth. So while oil spills can be pretty nasty, scientists are always looking for new and better solutions to cleaning them up. Another solution might be more environmentally friendly cars. Speaking of, the new Toyota Mirai is looking into the future with sustainability in mind, fueled by hydrogen and leaving zero emissions behind. To learn more about how we get oil out of the ground, check out this great video from Trace, where he explains where all of our oil comes from.
The first oil well was drilled in 1859 and could extract 800 gallons of crude a day, way more than anyone saw the need for at the time.
All right, got any other burning science questions for us? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We have new episodes every day of the week.